Welcome everyone. Today I did a snapshot metric video. What do I mean by a snapshot metric? I just took data over a fixed time period. So it was actually just one moment in time. I should have done this over a longer period of time, maybe weeks and months, and found the mean. That probably would have given more accurate information. But anyway, this is how I did this metric video. I went on CoinMarketCap, and I know there are others that will say, oh, you should have gone to this website or this website, but there may be slight variations between website to website, but I use CoinMarketCap. So we're going to just use CoinMarketCap as the standard for this video. Then I went to the cryptocurrency column and I found the top 10 cryptocurrencies. So ranging from number one, Bitcoin, all the way to number 10, Cardano. I went then found their market cap at a fixed time period. So I took the snapshot on April 21st, 2019 in the morning. And this is the market cap. So when you watch this video, it's probably going to be different. And I want you to leave comments, but don't leave comments saying that the market cap has changed, because obviously it's changing every second. So I did the most accurate thing that I could at that particular moment. Then I clicked on each of those cryptocurrencies and found the number of exchange pairs that they have. So what are exchange pairs? How you can get into that particular cryptocurrency. So for example, for Cardano, you may have ADA to BTC, ADA to Ethereum on Binance, ADA to BTC, ADA to Ethereum on Bittrex, and for every single exchange. And there may be different exchange pairs. I know that you can buy ADA with USD on Bittrex, but only if you are in particular states. So it doesn't work for every state within the United States. So that's that. And then after that, I took the market cap and divided it by the number of exchanges to find out how much money is actually added to the market cap after each added exchange pair. So every time an exchange pair is added to BTC, it adds around $233 million to the market cap. And we have a $2 billion market cap. So if we added that much money every time we add an exchange, that would be massive. But eventually, maybe that will happen. The reassuring thing is that the number of exchange pairs that each cryptocurrency has in the top 10, Cardano has the least. It has 73 ways that you can get ADA. And I hope this increases over time. But we're a fairly novel cryptocurrency. And I don't think we have reached our maximum potential, and it's still difficult to get ADA for most. For the traders and the people that are long-term hodlers, you understand how to navigate through exchanges. But for the everyday person that's just looking to maybe purchase it on Coinbase, it's not available yet. So the ease of use of getting ADA is still fairly difficult, in my opinion. So after that, I graphed it, and this is what the graph looks like. So every time we add an exchange pair, we add $25 million to the market cap, or $25 to $26 million to the market cap. What you can do is filter and see how much value is added. What are the new rankings for added value for exchange pairs? So for example, if all of us had the same number of exchanges, what would the rankings be? And if we sorted this, we see that Cardano is the fourth cryptocurrency as far as dollar amount value per added exchange pair. What does that tell you? It tells you that a lot of people are interested in Cardano, and every time it has a new method of purchasing Cardano or purchasing ADA, you're able to, the market cap significantly grows. And as you can see, some of our competitors are actually, they are on a lot more exchanges, but the amount added to their market cap after they're added to those exchanges or added exchange pairs is not as significant as Cardano or ADA. So we redid the graph and we're fourth right here. And this metric basically says the amount added to the market cap after each exchange pair. So let me know what you think, because also at the IOHK summit on Wednesday or Thursday, they had a private internal meeting between IOHK and exchanges. So there were exchanges at the event. I don't know who they were, but I'm sure they had a great closed door meeting, and I'm sure that new exchange pairs will be added in the future. Let me know what you think about this video. Let me know what you think about this metric. And I reiterate that it's not the most accurate metric because I just took a snapshot metric. I should have taken it over a period of time, but I did what I could. So enjoy your Sunday and talk to you later.